during the early Cenozoic. So so anyway, let's say that, you know, in the wintertime when light isn't penetrating as deep, they can just shut down. And or during a monsoon season. And so let's see. Because they can survive months of dormancy, they can the deepest dwellers can recruit from those transported propagules, grow very slowly, because they're going to be both food limited and light limited in their growth rates. Not much else is there because they're so food limited, so you have the low diversity, and they can produce asexually from time to time. If they grow, if they get to some sort of maturity, but the proportions, you'll still have the really large microspheric agamonts, and you'll have more of the smaller forms in most cases, but they won't be totally dominant like they are in shallower water. And of course, the capability of intermittent dormancy is a useful strategy of adaptation in, under these circumstances. So, and all of these parameters and hypotheses are supported by studies of large forams, or of forams in general. And so, and back to the people who thought they're the, you know, the researchers who said, oh no, there's some sorting in evidence. Well, major storms or internal waves, even occurring on decadal scales, could produce some of the sedimentary structures or evidence of winnowing that we see in these banks. And again, they were probably occurring at something over 50 meters depth, and sometimes, in some cases, over 100 meters depth, because their modern counterparts can live to those depths. And so, the new model, if you will, is that that the prominent large microspheric shells, bimodal size assemblages, dominated by only one or two species, can be in place. They accumulated very slowly, but nothing else was happening, basically. And rare turbulence events could remove any finer material and provide some evidence of winnowing. And of course, that hypothesis isn't new. It's pretty much just supporting Arne's original hypothesis. And but we can understand how they could occur in those kinds of environments based on what we know now about the foram biology, ecology, and ocean dynamics. And to be honest with you, geologists have only in the last decade, I think, or less than a decade, really picked up on internal waves and the potential influence of internal waves on carbonate systems. And again, these mechanisms aren't restricted to nummulitic facies. They're not restricted to Paleogene and Miocene times. And they do not, I'm not using them for shallow water accumulations. And so that's a new interpretation of something that we've known about for a long time. And Cesare Papazzoni and Mona Sade from Italy provided many of the pictures and discussions that helped develop this story. And was there one more thing I wanted to say? I can't remember. So thank you for your attention.